to celebrate the 19th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our second collection today is to help pay for the utilities of our parish buildings. Kindly make sure all cell phones are turned off before we begin our liturgy. Our Parish Activities Committee is planning a homemade food fest for August 29th. Volunteers are needed to help name City Chicken and Malushki. Please call the parish office or contact Shelley Lervick or Charlie Taromas if you can help in the preparation the week prior. Weekly candle intentions are available in both the main church and in Our Lady's Chapel. Please call the rectory office to remember your loved ones in this special way. St. Patrick Preschool registration for the 2020-21 school year is presently underway. Please call 570-622-0106 or see the bulletin for more information. If we wait to be adrift upon a stormy sea in order to see that God is present with us, we miss out on the grace and goodness that currently surrounds us. God's love is at work in us in every sacrament, in every moment of prayer, in every gathering of worship, in every act of kindness. He is the tiniest whisperer and in the outstretched hand of others. We remember at this Mass Margaret Kramer and Stephen Stonelake. Our presider is Father Barnes.
Thank you. Almighty and ever-living God, whom taught by the Holy Spirit, we dare to call our Father, bring, we pray, to perfection in our hearts the spirit of adoption as your sons and daughters, that you may merit to enter into the inheritance which you have promised through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the first book of Kings. At the mountain of God, Horeb, Elijah came to a cave where he took shelter. Then the Lord said to him, "Go outside and stand on the mountain before the Lord. The Lord will be passing by." A strong and heavy wind was rending the mountains and crushing the rocks before the Lord, but the Lord was not in the wind. After the wind there was an earthquake, but the Lord was not in the earthquake. After the earthquake, there was fire, but the Lord was not in the fire. After the fire, there was a tiny whispering sound. When he heard this, Elijah hid his face in his cloak and went and stood at the entrance of the cave. The word of the Lord. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I speak the truth in Christ, I do not lie. My conscience joins with the Holy Spirit in bearing me witness that I have great sorrow and constant anguish in my heart. For I could wish that I myself were accursed and cut off from Christ for the sake of my own people, my kindred according to the flesh. They are Israelites. There's the adoption, the glory, the covenants, the giving of the law, the worship, and the promises. There's the patriarchs, and from them, according to the flesh, is the Christ, who is over all, God blessed forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
For some reasons, he left them on their own. When went out alone on the mountain to pray, when he came to see them, they couldn't recognize him. When Matthew uses the image of a boat, Matthew uses the image of a boat as an image of the church. And so I want you to think of a church as a big boat, whereby all of us get into this boat with the Lord on the very first day when we said yes, when the Lord invited each one of us through the sacrament of baptism, and we became his disciples. We said yes, we want to follow him. And we got into this big boat. And when we said so with the Lord, everything was okay. Any moment we try to stay away from him, then we experience, as Peter did, a great fear, a great anxiety. And so we begin to cry out, Lord, where are you? Don't you see that we are sinking? And the Lord will say, here I am. He will stretch out his hand and say to you, do not be afraid. It is until we have to call out to him, dear brothers and sisters, to show our desire, our longing for him, and he will let us know he has not left us. You see, for the disciples in the gospel reading, they felt that the Lord had abandoned them. And so they were terrified. You look at the church today, you just get to think of how many people in this big boat of the church who had been in before, and when they saw the church, as it were, tossed by the great waves and winds of this world, they jumped out. They left. And if you ask them, why did you leave? They say, Jesus left us. He has not left us. We live with him. The same experience of the disciples. They thought the Lord had left them. And now here they are in the middle of the sea, the middle of the lake, and the waves are coming, and they don't know what to do next. And Jesus comes to meet them. They would even recognize him. The same Jesus that knew with him before. And then, when Peter, on behalf of the rest of the disciples, cried out, Lord, we are sinking. Jesus says, do not be afraid. My dear brothers and sisters, we all have our fears, we all have our anxieties in life. We have our own challenges, and sometimes we think the Lord has left us. For the disciples, they were in the boat. Maybe for us, we don't have to be in the boat, but what goes on in our life sometimes makes us think that the Lord has abandoned us. Think of the times when just even in the family, at the beginning, things are good in the family. Then all of a sudden, something begins going wrong in the family. There's no good relationship. Probably don't talk to one another. You don't have the time to sit at the table and have a meal together. And then you wonder, has the Lord left us? Has the Lord abandoned us? What is happening to my family? Or maybe you are well, no one is sick in the family. And then as time goes by, one person gets sick, the other one gets sick, the other one gets sick. And you wonder, has the Lord abandoned us? What is going on? Or at the place of work, you get a very good employment. Things go on well at the very beginning. 2, 3, 4, 5 years down the road, things are no longer going good. nor could you walk in relationship among your companions. And then you begin asking yourself, what's going on in my life? Has the Lord abandoned me? Now, when good things come to our life, what must we do? That's what then the first reading answers that question. You know, the prophet goes out looking for the Lord. And the strong wind and the fire and all kinds of disturbances are out there, and the Lord was not there. Then finally, in a very quiet atmosphere, in a very quiet place, he recognized, he felt the presence of the Lord. For us, dear brothers and sisters, when we are confronted with the storms of our own lives, fears of our own lives, what must we do? Go to a quiet place. You could go to the church and sit there and pray. You could go to a meditation chapel and have a time to pray. Or maybe even in your own home, in a very quiet place, sit and pray. Listen to what the Lord is speaking to you. Remember the gospel? Jesus, when he left the disciples, he went up on the mountain alone to pray in a quiet place. And there, the Spirit of the Lord speaks to him. And that's why he's giving us a very good lesson. When we are challenged, when we are confronted with the fears beyond our energy, our ability, it's not the time to rush and give a judgment, but rather the time to pray quietly and asking the Lord, what must I do? Because, my dear brothers and sisters, none of us is free from fear. None of us is free from challenges of the life. None of us is free from anxieties and worries of what today and maybe even tomorrow. But then, when we are confronted with such fears, Peter, what must we do? Pray. And then, call out courageously and say, Lord, I am sinking. Where are you? My family is sinking. Or maybe my marriage is sinking. My working relationship is sinking. And what must I do? And the Lord will say to you, do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. Rather, he will stretch his hand and say, do not be afraid. Why? Because he will never leave us. Even at those moments when we feel that the Lord has left us, he has not left us. And that's what Peter then represents to each one of us. At the moment of fear, he said, Lord, where are you? And the Lord, who never left him, stretched out his hand, got hand of Peter while he was sinking, and got into the boat. Now guess what? When Jesus got into the boat, everything was okay. That's what happens, my dear brothers and sisters, in our ordinary life. As I say, when we experience challenges, difficulties, and some kind of all kinds of fears in our life, invite the Lord in prayer. Say, Lord God, come to my life. Come to our family, even come to our place of work, and help to calm down the storms that we are experiencing. And he will do it, because, as he says, I am always with you to the end of time. And here we are, dear brothers and sisters, more with faith and great courage. We want to continue to follow the ways of the Lord. We want to continue to allow him to be part of our life. And we want to continue to invite him to be with us, even in the moments of trouble, in the moment of great storms in our own lives, because you will calm them. Nothing is impossible before the Lord. And so, with the courage, with the faith, we want to continue to be there, and He will be there for us. Why? Because, as I say, He has invited each one of us to become His disciple, and He will never abandon us.
Father, will continue to bless our Pope Francis and all our bishops as successors of Peter and the Apostles with good health and vitality during the present health crisis in the world. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
That the Lord will grant all who serve in public office hearts of justice and compassion. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
That all in the military who serve throughout the world and their families will be surrounded with the grace and protection of the Holy Spirit. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
That all in our faith community will have the strength to resist the temptation to discriminate against the poor, the immigrant, the elderly, and the unborn. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
That God will renew in all who are burdened with any manner of suffering, and all who have asked us to pray for them, a hope that brings consolation and peace. Lord, in your mercy. That Jesus, the divine physician, will bring comfort and healing to all who have suffered in any way from the effects of the COVID-19 virus pandemic. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
That all who have died marked with the sign of faith, those who have died unremembered and unmourned, will be welcomed into the eternal life God gives through his Son. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
That Mark Kramer and Stephen Stonelake, whom we remember at this Mass, will always share in the eternal banquet. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
And for those petitions we hold in the silence of our hearts. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Loving God, hear these prayers as we seek to be the hands and feet of Jesus each day. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just our generous celebration. Always and everywhere to give your thanks, Lord, your Holy Father. Almighty and eternal God, who was born in this day, and by his suffering, he canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so, with the company of angels and the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end, we are men. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more gave them thanks. Gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." All glory and honor is yours forever. said to the apostles, they shall save you by grace again. Look not on our sins, but in the faith of your church, and graciously grant you our peace and unity in accordance with your will. Good day for men, forever and ever. May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Thank you.
desire to receive into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually to my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there. I unite myself only to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Let us pray. May the communion in your sacrament that we have consumed serve us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth through Christ our Lord. Amen. Prayer to combat the corona pandemic. Most merciful and triumphant God, we come to you in your weakness, we come to you in our fear. We come to you with a trust, for you alone, our God. We place before you the disease present in our world. We turn to you in our time of need. Bring wisdom to doctors, give understanding to scientists, and oh, give us the compassion and generosity. Bring healing to those who are ill. Protect those who are the most at risk. Give comfort to those who have lost the loved one. Welcome those who have died in the eternal home. Stabilize our communities. Unite us in our compassion. Remove all of fear from our hearts. Fill us with confidence in your care. Jesus, I trust in you. Jesus, I trust in you. Jesus, I trust in you.